You're still watching Waze on Plus TV Africa. So an unknown author once said, good things come to those who sweat. So Seyi Olusore is the MD CEO of Shedem's Fitness. He is the brain behind Nigeria's first weight loss reality TV show, The Fastest Shredder. Now remember, you can join the conversation. Twitter us at Plus TV Africa or at Waze Show Africa 1 with the hashtag Waze. Or you send an SMS to 081-803-84663. Thanks for joining us, Seyi.
My pleasure. Thank you so very much.
Okay, so where do we start from? Should we start from the quote that we had today?
Okay.
Because a lot of times I just feel like we feel Nigerians have the habit, or will I call it Africans? I don't know about, but we just have the habit that if the food is not so much, yeah, first of all, we won't be full. Yeah. And secondly, we are not eating, you know, the right amount of quantity to sustain us, you know. Is that a myth, or is that something that we have just decided to adopt?
Well, I think it's an adopted mentality, mm-hmm, which eventually does not help, because bulk of the issues most persons have with the doctors and the hospitals is because the doctors, after going through the cholesterol check, they tell them that they have high cholesterol. Mm-hmm. Now, you don't have to be obese to have high cholesterol, mm-hmm, you know. So what the mistake we do is we go for the quantity instead of quality. And quality in the food would always outweigh the quantity. So the quote you had earlier on, like, you eat, we're meant to eat to live, not live to eat. Mm-hmm. And that's because, well, Nigerians, we eat what our mouth wants, not what the body needs. That's the mistake we make, you know. And I'm of the opinion that, yes, you don't have to cut out a certain class of food in trying to stay healthy. You know, earlier of, behind the scenes, we were talking about spaghetti. You know, you can take your spaghetti, but portioned.
Yeah.
Yes, moderately. Because you need to, then what do you now eat afterwards? Do you take fruits? Do you, you know, detox regularly? Mm-hmm. Do you take plenty of water? Like, on the table now, I'm the only one having water. Yeah, you can call all this. This is the only drink.
It's iced tea, guys. It's very healthy.
Yeah, it's very healthy. But it will interest you to know that this is the only drink that has zero calories. Yeah. Do you get? So call it whatever you want, but it's still healthy for you.
After today, don't worry.
Yeah,
Faith, you have a
question. So I wanted to ask, so a lot of people say that they don't have enough money to join the gym. So do you have any suggestions on workout routines that they can do from the comfort of their homes to stay active?
Yeah, so this is 2020. There's no excuse. You know, excuses don't burn calories.
Yes.
You know, in your house, you can actually work out with your chair. You can actually do stuff like just go up, down, side. These are exercises. These are functional routines that you can do.
How many minutes?
15 minutes. Although the World Health Organization recommends 30 minutes on a daily basis to stay healthy. And it's all about cardio, your heart. Your heart health is way more important. So you can just stretch, do little exercises like this, you know, helps your obliques. You know, you can breathe in. Do breathing exercises. That's a form of yoga.
Okay.
So you don't have to go all the way to the gym. You can work out anywhere as long as you're burning calories.
And as far as you're moving.
Yes.
Okay, based on a research by Harvard Health blog, there is they had a research made on 123,000 people between the ages of 30 to 75. They gave them the different, benchmarks, which were they had different habits, actually, eating habits.
Okay.
They don't drink, they don't eat
junk
food, and at the same time, no alcohol, they were not overweight, and they were physically active. Mm. So in the process of this, during the process of these, research, we have a few of them died. Let's see, about 42,167 participants actually died. Now, they also checked that this was as a result of cancer or cardiovascular diseases.
Yeah.
Now, also, they also noticed that 74% of those without any of these traits or these bad habits, eating habits, they were the ones that actually survived. 74% of them. Now the question is, how do we create awareness to these people or to the youth out there for them to be able to comprehend the essence of healthy eating or healthy living?
Yeah, well, that's why some of us, we try to preach the gospel of fitness, because when you stay active, you don't get to fall sick often. Mm-hmm. Then you said something, cardiovascular diseases.
You know, yes.
When it comes to cardio, it has to do with your heart. Like I said, anything that has to do with, you know, this part of your body is your cardio. So that means your heart has to be pumping blood regularly. And if the pores, the arteries and all the veins that's supposed to pass the blood is blocked with cholesterol and all the things you eat, it makes it hard for the blood, for the heart to pump blood. So you need to work out regularly. You need to exercise
regularly. I like the fact that you brought the working out regularly. So how regular is a healthy workout? So in terms of, okay, do I do it once a week? And what are the things I need to do? So for me, I take long walks, but I've stopped for a while because I moved houses and this new location is not favorable for the long walk. So I've been trying to see how I can start something else, pending when the conditions are favorable. So what is a healthy workout routine that you would recommend for someone that wants to stay alive?
Yeah, like I always say, the bad workout there is the one you didn't do. And that's because, like I said earlier, it's all about functional training. You go to work, you use the staircase. Some persons would rather use the lift. That is totally off point. You need to use the staircase. You don't have to go in your cars every time. You can walk that distance. Walking is a very good way of burning calories. You can also skip. That's what we call burpees, just up. And that's why some persons, if you walk, a short distance, you start panting. When you start panting and gasping for breath, you need to check yourself. You're not fit. You need to be very, very fit. So it's very pertinent that, 3 times a week is good on average to work off at 30 minutes.
On an average, but 3 times a week. A lot of people sometimes they bring up what's it called, healthy living, and most times the first thing that comes to their mind is weight loss. So can we try to correct that? Because a lot of people just say, because I want to lose weight and all of that.
Now, weight loss is just one of the many benefits of
healthy living.
Take exercise in quote. So if I'm not on the big side, but I exercise to keep fit. Like on my way here, I was stuck in traffic. I just got down. I got down and I was walking. It's part of me. There's so many instances where I've been stuck in traffic, and because the fitness person in me, I need to burn calories. And another thing is, I need my skin to be fresh.
To be popping.
I don't use the kind of cream. I don't even use cream. I use coconut
Vaseline.
Oil. Coconut oil. But because I take in fruits regularly, and pawpaw, cucumber, all these things.
So how effective are fruits to our healthy living?
They're very, very effective because they help when it comes to immunity against sickness. Vitamins, nutrients from raw fruits, they would help prevent sicknesses. And now that it's Ramadan, you take oranges. Oranges are very high in vitamin C.
Okay.
They are going to help prevent all this.
Flus and whatnot.
Yes.
So like now it's New Year's and people come up with New Year resolutions. Yeah. And most of the time people like incorporate eating well into their New Year's resolution. So how do people select a healthy diet? How do they go around that?
Well, for me, I'd say, because it's what are you saying? So I'm saying that, let no one deceive you with healthy jargons or a fat diet. As long as your meals contain the micro and macronutrients, take for example now your proteins, milk, low cholesterol milk, then a little bit of goat's meat. I won't tell you to go and take
meat.
Good, Then Greek yogurt.
That
can be healthy too for you.
But not everybody can afford Greek yogurt.
Okay.
We're going there. Continue.
you know, then you can have oatmeal.
Okay.
I love oat. Yes. I love oat every day.
It's high in fiber, yes, which helps with your digestive system.
You are just calling all these expensive.
So now, we're going to the financial...
Yeah, she said it's expensive, but to treat all of these things is more expensive.
Yeah, but we're going to the financial implications for all of these things now, because somebody is starting the new year, and we want everybody to be alive December 31st, 2020. We want everybody to be alive. So, and it's important that... You know, people think it's the big things that count when it comes to healthy living. Yeah. But it is the little things that count. Yeah. You know, so how do we stay healthy on a budget? Because healthy living is not cheap.
At all.
When you try to buy all the fruits and all the veggies and all of that to actually eat junk is cheaper. You know?
Way,
way cheaper to eat junk.
And faster.
Really? Is it?
And it's faster. Cheaper to eat junk.
Yes.
Wow. When you want to buy junk, it's cheaper than when you are buying a healthy salad, for instance. So tell us, how do we work on a budget with that?
Okay. Now, an average malam sells an apple for 15 naira.
Who told you 15 naira? It's not.
Okay.
Let's say 100 naira. There are different types. There are different types.
Even that tiny one now is 100 naira.
And how much is a cone of ice cream? Cake.
Well,
pizza.
A scoop of ice cream is that, you know?
Yeah, so from, well, the trick around it, because I deal with Nigerian foods. Mm. Now, you can cook your vegetable without oil. Do you know that?
Tasteless. Okay. Bland.
Says who? What if I told you that sometimes you don't even need to add all this seasoning and all of that to your chicken? I mean,
Sorry, no.
Now you lost me.
Have you tried it?
No. You lost me.
Have you tried it?
You don't need to put all. It is totally tasteless and bland.
I do that, and I love it. My okra.
No, so you don't know how to cook.
I don't put oil there. My when I'm frying plantain, I have this air fryer. I don't put oil there. Mm. But I need to leave healthy.
Let me say something. Let me say something. There are some people who actually do all these.
Yes.
They go through all the process of, you know, keeping healthy, living a good life, you know. But at the end of the day, they still end up having these diseases, such as cancerous diseases and cardiovascular diseases. And they die as a result of it.
One thing must kill a man, yeah? Yeah. But the truth of the matter is, when you eat healthy...
So what causes it?
Well, maybe...
Genetics.
It's time for them to come home or something. We've got this
So
there's no explanation for it.
No, but the truth of the matter is, if you eat healthy, you're going to live longer.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's the truth. You're actually going to even look younger.
Younger.
You know,
I can attest to that. And let's get serious. Now. Yeah. So I am, let's say that I am living in a very unhealthy space right now, and I want to start. Where is the best place to start? In terms of, should I start with exercise, should I start with food, or what is, just tell me, how do I start?
Oh, well, the best.
Somebody's out there right now feeling hopeless and all that. We want to help that person. How can they get started?
Okay. Now, in your fitness healthy journey, one thing that takes 70% is the diet.
Okay.
You need to, first thing you do is take water in the morning, because that was also going to clean your body system and, you know, create room for a faster bowel movement. You know, you need to take at least 200 cl of water every day.
Wow.
At least that sachet is about 50 cl. I think you just take four of that on the average.
Okay.
You know, so that alone would keep your body hydrated, improve your body metabolism.
Okay.
You know, body metabolism, how well your body is able to process your food and burn fat.
This with water, that, should it be cold water or warm water?
No.
Because some people don't.
So
it's okay for one to take cold water in the morning then?
Yeah. If you want to take cold water is water. It's going to cleanse your system. And in terms of exercises, you know, when you first wake up in the morning, you can just stretch. Now, stretching will help improve mobility and flexibility in your body. It doesn't allow you to have muscle pulls,
cramps,
and all of that. So all of that, you know, it's all about accountability.
Okay.
You know, I used to tell people that I can't be fit on your behalf. It's all about you. Yes.
Yeah.
And this thing, it's no quick fix. Mm-hmm. You've gone ahead to do Dirty December. Now you now want to do Dirty January. Now what happens to February, March, April, May? You know, it's a lifestyle. It's not a quick fix.
Mm-hmm.
You know, there's no shortcut to this thing, because for persons on the big side, they tell you, I want to lose weight in 2 weeks. But I question them that, did you add in 2 weeks? No, you didn't add that weight in 2 weeks. So you need to just, you know, ensure that you stick to that regimen. you staying fit, healthy, and accountable to yourself.
So in summation, you've said that we have to eat a lot of fruits. Yeah. We should take a lot of water, minimum of 200 cl every day on a diet. Then we should have a fitness diet. And at the same time, we should go for quality food and not quantity.
So how about trainers, personal trainers? Do we all really need a personal trainer?
If I tell you that we don't need a personal trainer, I'm shooting myself in the leg.
Yeah.
Nobody wants to. You need a personal trainer because you need to. There's some things you won't know on yourself. But like for me now, if I'm going to do a personal training session with you, I have exercises that target
a specific goal.
Yes, you
How
know.
Do you get flat tummies?
That is one. Consult with him. Thank you so much. So I think personal trainers, you know, sometimes. I'll leave it there. Yeah. Sometimes they, you know, sometimes people feel they have a misconception that it's healthy. But when you check, I like what you said in the beginning, that if you check, compare the cost of what you're going to pay afterwards, it's better to pay it now.
Yes.
Yeah, so that's why it would be important to have a personal trainer and have someone to hold you accountable, you know, to living that healthy lifestyle.
Yeah.
All right, so we have Oluseye Adeoronke. She will join us after the break. Please stay with us.